Hello beautiful people and welcome back again to my channel. It is I, me, your favorite baby girl DJ is here as always. Thank you so much for clicking to watch this video. I really appreciate it. Guys, in today's video, we will be sharing with you places you might not enjoy electricity in Ibadan. You may find yourself in those places, my sister. You're on your own, no. As you guys can see, we have our guest in here. Say hello.
Hello.
You will not mention your name now before I mention it for you.
Yeah.
I believe you guys saw her in our last video. So, okay, now can we just, you know, places that you've actually, you feel like, oh, you know people that live there, or probably you've witnessed or something. Okay. So, let's just start. For me, number one place, Adugbo. On my list is Apete area. You guys, that is Songo area, like Pony area rather. Oh my god, light over there is poor. When I mean poor, not F9, this one is G10, honestly. Are you surprised? Honestly, light over there, you guys, is not, it's not even any, like, nothing to write home about, honestly. So yeah, if you have to relocate to Ibadan, probably you're a student, you want to move it to Ibadan, you're a poly student or something, please, okay, I will advise you. The only thing that you can enjoy some places is if you have solar. Even Jane, if you have Jane, you will spend a whole lot.
Some people are used to that, they don't mind.
What, how about the noise?
The noise, they are used to it, they don't mind.
Okay, well, if you don't mind, but anything outside that. And another thing about that area is accommodation is not cheap. Quote my words. Accommodation over there is not cheap. Which one do you have on your list?
I think Olodo.
Yeah, Olodo, you guys. Olodo, that's true. Olodo is a very beautiful place. Like, it's a new developing area in Ibadan, honestly. Accommodation over there are quite affordable. Like, two bedroom flats, you can see for 200k, 150k. Yeah. Three bedroom, 150k, 200k. But light over there, you guys. No. Don't go to that area. Don't tell me I'll not tell you.
They can go if they want to.
Don't say I not tell you. Accommodation there is quite cheap, but light over there is,
it's not,
is bad. No, don't say not that is. See, okay, let's call it spade.
It's
spade.
It is bad. Like, it is bad.
Yeah. Another one on my list that I'll talk about is Ajibode area. Those are places that.
And this is the interesting part about that place, that it's a student area, like, oh, yes, student-dominated area.
In that area, they have citizens, indigenous as well. That
yes,
there, but lies around that place. And the annoying part of this particular area is accommodation there are not cheap.
Very
affordable.
Considering the fact that you know students now, when you tell them this, they don't have a choice.
From school.
Their school environment.
That's true. You guys, light over there is nothing to write on my glass. Please, if you want to, my advice from me, your favorite baby girl, is please don't go to that area at all, okay? Don't near that area. Next on your list is
Akpata.
Yeah, you guys, Akpata, oh my god. Guys, accommodation over there are not affordable. You will be seeing two bedroom flats for like 600,000 naira. And
like
lights,
good places
too. Yeah, good. But how about the lights over there? And even the road is not that okay. Don't let me go there. But honestly, I feel like in it areas
where they don't have good lights, at least there should be a sort of encouragement
for goodness' sake.
With the prices and everything.
Yeah, but it's just so amazing that's another part of it's another world on its own. So Akpata area is not that place. They will tell you, agents will tell you, oh, in Odagbo is good, but honestly, people that lives over there, they can tell you that. They know, honestly. So please, if you find yourself in Ibadan and you are thinking of places to see, if you want to consider electricity, at least you need like 60%.
Yeah.
Please don't go to that area, okay? So on my list, another place that I would like to talk about is Akedemi, Olomi. You guys,
it's Olomi, don't forget that.
Olomi Jojolo. See, that place is not, in fact, I think from Akedemi, Olomi to Mobolu Waji or something, okay, to Soka, those area. Please don't go there because electricity over there are just poor. Trust me. Well, like, 2-3 days. I think, okay, there was a day I entered one bus and the man was, okay, they were talking about electricity generally inside the taxi. And the man was like, ah, wala, what it also can't. And I asked the man that how will she want to survive? How about your fridge? How about everything? And he was like, every night he do powers a fridge freezer for like 4 hours, and that will sustain it for the next 20. Yeah, as in, I was not like 1 month. Said it's not as if we don't have.
The only interesting part is they'll still pay.
Yes, and yeah, they still pay.
Yeah,
they pay. And it was like at some point, you know, the what's it called? Youth around that area, they protest and they were like, NEPA, if you come to our area, we're not gonna pay you this, that. But at the end of the whole thing, they still pay. So if you find your see, even if they want to sell land for you, I would advise you. It's just an advice. Maybe in the future, probably. Yeah, probably in the future. That area they might have, like, but as of now that we're filming this video, trust me, and even before we came to Ibadan, because at some point I asked one of my friends that was born and brought up around that area, and she was like, they are already used to that system. So, but maybe in the future, Shad, they will start having like, okay, another place that you have on your list is where?
Moniya.
Moniya, yeah, you guys, Moniya is that, you know, big area as well in Ibadan, like, it's another world on its own. But electricity over there, you guys, you know, few places, like few, just go to my wall, like electricity over there is, if we are to rate it, we'll tell you that electricity is
below average,
below 10. You understand? I don't want to say it with all my mouth. So another place that I would like to talk about again is Monoton area, right from onset, according to my research, because I do ask people questions a lot, and they were like, they don't really have that good life right from onset. So Monoton is not that area that will actually advise you to move to or to live in if you are considering electricity in Ibadan. And houses over there as well is affordable. It's not cheap, neither expensive. But electricity is nothing to write home about. Yeah, another place I would like us to talk about is Apeiri. That axis, you guys. Oh my god, that place. Guys, see, Orita Apeiri is not. Please don't go there. It is an advice, please. But if you have money for solar, like we said earlier, you can decide
all
to
these
move.
Things are not problems.
They are not problems. So are, those areas are, it's not as if they are bad like that, so you get. But if you have money for solar and probably generator, maybe Meccano, it's good. Oshé, maybe. So it's good. You can decide to move to those areas. You
but
can do.
The fact that the, what is it called? Accommodation are actually
good for me. Yeah, but if you are to calculate the amount of diesel, fuel, or something that you'll be paying for, you'll know that it's actually better you rent apartment of 400,000 than renting apartment of 200,000 and having to spend like 250 or probably 300k yearly for what's it called, fuel, diesel, and whatever. And if you have probably if you have business, you can do businesses as well in those areas.
Yes,
it's not as if those areas are bad though. Don't, but we are just talking based on electricity. Please, oh, you get it. Okay, there are so many places as well in Ibadan that they, you know, electricity are just average. So that's why we didn't mention a lot of places, because their electricity is average. So that's it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe.
Comment.
And leave your comment at the comment section. We will see you guys in our next video. Bye.